Searching for inspiration for a new project, I came across some previously saved works on Pinterest. The links lead to Thomas Dubois' art station page, where we can find more similar works. The lighting and composition are very striking, and I wanted to see if I could achieve a similar vibe and how close I could get to Thomas using Blender. Thomas calls some of his work cyberpunkish, although it is not classic street cyberpunk, we have some cyberpunk features, especially in the lighting. For this work, I will only use assets that I have created or that I will create specifically for this project to make this video as creative as possible. The idea is to have some kind of coffee bar in middle of the composition with people in it. So I started looking for inspiration and came across this photo and immediately thought this could be our coffee bar. I also added some large flat textures to the collage so that I would have more projection options later in the UV editor. First I started with a cube onto which I project the texture with Project From View and later roughly corrected the projection in the UV editor. Later I added more details, first larger and then smaller, and in parallel I fixed the projection in the UV editor. I recorded the entire process of modeling a texture in the container house, as well as the creation of the entire scene in real time. So you can watch a tutorial listing about 4 hours on my Gumroad page or on Patreon in the links below for those who want to learn more. The first part of the tutorial is free. This part is a time-lapse video cut from parts of the tutorial. Now that we have the basic shape, we can add more details. In this part, I mainly follow the texture and model the windows according to the texture and at the same time fix the UV projection. I also created a glass material along the way. For the roughness, I used the concrete texture to add more detail and a little bump with the noise texture, and in the color input I kept a little texture from the glass reference to get more detail. Even though the glass shouldn't have any color variation. The side doesn't have any usable texture, so I decided to project everything onto this door texture and then model the window from the eye. The ladder is created with wireframe option in edit mode, shortcut is CTRL+F. You can also use the wireframe modifier, but this is faster if you don't need non-destructive option. The second side is just a copy of the first. I created the basic shape of the fence with faces, then kept only the edges and added bevels in some places. After that, I converted the edges into a curve to which I added depth and then converted curve to mesh. Later I played with the material and projection. First I projected everything onto the texture of the metal door and later I tried to project at least some parts onto the fence from the reference. If you want to learn modeling, texturing or any part of Blender and don't have a lot of time in your day, this is my advice. Watch at least one video every day. For example, 5-minute long video on a topic that interests you. At first you will be confused, but later more and more things will become familiar to you and you will learn much faster. And after, for example, a year, you will realize that you know a lot. Of course, practice is important and you will need bigger projects later, but with this small daily habit, you will make your job much easier. 5 minutes of learning a day gives much better result than, for example, 35 minutes once a week, because in those 6 days in between, you forget what you learned the previous week. I have a habit of saving videos that I find interesting into playlists, and I try to watch something from some of the playlists every day. For this reason, when I create tutorials, I always divide them into a large number of small lessons so that people can organize their learning more easily. This is how all my step-by-step tutorials are created. The playlist is just an example. There are also apps that are designed specially for this type of learning, and one of them is Brilliant, which is also the sponsor of this video. Brilliant is based on short daily lessons and challenges, listing a few minutes that you receive in your inbox every day. With thousands of interactive lessons in math, science, programming, data analysis and AI, Brilliant helps you get smarter every day. To make learning easier and more fun, each lesson is filled with hands-on problem solving that lets you play with concepts. A method proven to be 6 times more effective than watching lecture videos. Brilliant is accessible via web browser and has mobile apps for iOS and Android. The Brilliant app makes it easy to learn anywhere right on your phone, with fun hands-on lessons you can do whenever you have time. Brilliant also offers Python lessons, so if you are interested in developing plugins for Blender or creating automated workflows in Blender, Brilliant is a great place to start learning Python. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, you can visit link in description or scan the QR code you can see on screen. You will also get 20% of annual premium subscription. Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video, let's back to Blender now. In this part, I mostly follow the reference image and try to add more details. Cables are also very easy to create. If you add a curve object and delete it in edit mode, you get draw curve option on the left, which is very useful in cases like this. For the scene I am creating, I don't need that much detail because everything is in shadow. But since I plan to include it in my industrial decoration asset pack, I put effort into the details. In the end, with the same concrete texture, I added more details in roughness, bump and metallic input. I actually created the same model twice. The first time without recording for the asset pack, the second time when I decided to record the process for the tutorial. You can see both results here. Now that we have the central part of the composition, we can start building the scene. I started with a vertical camera at the height of 20 meters, with a 200 by 200 plane and black color in world settings. The buildings in the background are from my editing building asset pack. This is how the creation process looks like. You can see more about the buildings in this video on the channel. In this part, I place the buildings in the background, for which I use low poly city blocks. Buildings closer to camera have much more details. To get this street light effect, I plugged this random image from the internet into emission and emission strength, and place it at the bottom. This light will not have a strong impact later when I add volumetric hue with a greenish color and a little emission strength. After the background and lighting, it is time for the asset closer to the camera. Here I am using assets from the industrial decoration asset pack, but mostly large structures because small ones wouldn't be visible. For easier navigation into a large scenes like this, I changed the viewport navigation to lock to 3D cursor. Now I can simply place 3D cursor with shift right click and easily and precisely zoom to a specific location. This is very important when working with large scale scenes. Here, finally our main star takes his place. This should be a coffee bar, so we should also build a terrace. In addition to the industrial decoration asset pack, I also use several shop assets and neon sign assets that I had created earlier. Shop assets have built-in lights, so they create a lot of details and give the impression that someone lives here. Coffee neon sign is exactly what we need. You can find all asset packages and tutorials in the links in the description. On Gumroad and Superhive, you can make one-time purchase of a product, while on Patreon, you can download all assets with a single subscription. This is the final result I get straight from the blender, and this is after post-processing. It looks like it requires a lot of work in post-processing to get closer to the reference image, but in fact we can do a lot with just one action. If you look at the reference image, we see a lot of fog in the background, quite bright and vibrant colors. The fog is placed right behind the main structure to create a strong contrast and separate the main part from the background. We can create this effect quickly and easily with the mist pass and for example with light green color behind the main structure. With the mist pass, we control where we want and how intense the overlay will be. That's the basic idea, but if instead of a flat green color we use a high quality fog overlay, we get much more realistic and detailed look, much closer to the reference image. I downloaded this fog overlay for free in the description of this video, the link to that video is below. It is necessary to create more layers and play with more overlays for a better result, but the difference before and after is very big. Thank you. I added other things such as color correction and some minor effects in After Effects, but they can be easily done in Blender as well. For example, to highlight the neon signs, I added a simple solid plane with a color similar to the neon sign, which I cut out in places where there is no neon sign, set the screen blending mode and added a feather. That's it for this video. If you are interested in other effects and the whole 4-hour modeling process, look for it on Patreon, Superhive or the Gumroad link in the description.